عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to a new video of how to action verb series. Today we're going to learn how to draw a graph. A graph is a drawing that shows how a factor of an experiment varies as a function of another factor in this experiment. So it is a drawing that can explain the result of the experiment or show the result of the experiment. And we can, by viewing it, we can study how the measured factor changed as a function of the manipulated factor. يعني هو رسمة رسم بيانة بفرجينا تأثير عامل على عامل تاني بالتجربة اللي عم نعملها. Now a graph should contain the following elements. First, two perpendicular axes x and y, يعني خطين متعامدين, واحد اسمه x اللي هو بيكون أفقي, واحد بيكون عمودي اسمه y. So the two perpendicular axes, one is horizontal, which is the x-axis, and the other, which is vertical, is the y-axis. The curve that represents the variation, and this curve is done by plotting some points and joining these points together. The curve, يعني المنحنى, الرسم اللي بتطلع معنا اللي بتنتج عن وضع النقاط معينة وتوصيل هولي النقاط. And finally, a title, a scale, and sometimes a key or legend. Like any other drawing or diagram, the graph needs a title to show what it shows, to clear up what it shows for the reader, a scale, and we'll talk about it later, and sometimes a key when needed. فأذن مثل أي رسمة علمية تانية, الجراف بدو عنوان, بدو مقياس, وبدو مفتاح أوقات حسب نوع الجراف. Now let's make an example and try to draw a graph. We have this experiment here in order to study the variation of temperature of alcohol. As a function of time of boiling, we place a flask containing alcohol on a heater. The observed results are illustrated in the following table at different time intervals. So here in this experiment, the objective, and even if you are only asked to draw a graph, it's important to know the objective of the experiment. We wanted to study the variation of temperature of alcohol as a function of time of boiling. Now, we notice here that as an experiment, there are the manipulated factor and the measured factor. In this experiment, it's very clear that the manipulated factor is the time of boiling, okay, or boiling, while the measured factor is the temperature of alcohol. So when we know the factors, drawing the graph will become very easy. As you see here, this is the table that shows the data that we're going to change into a graph. فإذن عنا هاي الاكسبرمنت, مثل أي اكسبرمنت اللي عندها العوامل, العامل اللي نحن بنشتغل عليه اللي هو المانيبوليتد فاكتور, والعامل اللي بنقيسه آخر شيء. العامل اللي نحن غيرناه, اللي نحن عدلناه, هو وقت الغليان للألكهول, قدي عم نغلي وقت, بينما العامل المقاس اللي عم نقيسه هو درجة حرارة الألكهول على كل وقت. هلأ صار وقت نشوف كيف بدنا نحول هيدي التابل لجراف. The steps, the main steps of drawing a graph is first we draw the axes and name each one. And here we have to pay attention that the manipulated factor goes on the x-axis, on the horizontal axis, and the measured factor goes on the y-axis. Now here there is a note here that sometimes the x-axis doesn't show the manipulated factor. The manipulated factor is shown in another way. We'll see how later on. Okay? Okay, now we'll go to this graph paper. Okay, we see it's organized and cut into each box is 1 centimeter. And of course we need a ruler. We don't draw a graph without a ruler. We start by drawing the vertical axis, okay, then the horizontal axis, and when we're done, we will start naming the axis. Now, we have to put an arrowhead on each axis, okay? And we will name each axis. We said that the manipulated factor goes on the x-axis, which is time of boiling. So we write it here. We shouldn't forget it at all. Of course, we write the unit. And on the y-axis goes the measured factor, which is the temperature of alcohol, of course, in degree 7. After we've done this step, let's go back to see what's the next step. The next step is to assign a scale for each action. Now, when we say assign a scale, we mean that the scale is a numbering of the axes in a certain pattern. We should not copy the numbers as they are in the table. Here, pay attention, please. The scale is to number the axes in a certain pattern. For example, we number each 1 centimeter represents 1 minute or 2 minutes or 5 minutes. But what we should not do at all is to copy the numbers as they are on the axis. Okay, so let's see the numbers here. We see that the time goes, for example, 0, 1, 5, 15, 20, 25, 27, 30. So we here see that it increases about by 5 minutes each time. Of course, there's the 1, there's the 27, but in general, the time is increasing by 5 minutes. Now, the temperature, look at the temperature, it's a little different. It increases by 15. 15, 18, 46, 60, 72. So here we have to think about the scale we're going to do. So let's go here back to the graph. We will assign first for the x-axis each one box, okay, is 5 minutes. So we start putting the dots like this. We chose to make the scale on the x-axis. Each two boxes 5 minutes, and on the y-axis each two boxes will be 15 degrees Celsius. So we did them like this, and we have to write the scale here, okay, to show which scale did we achieve. The scale each two boxes in y-axis is 5 minutes, and on x-axis is 5 minutes, and on y-axis is 15 degrees Celsius. Now let's go back to see the next step. We have to plot the points, then join them. And here, we have to join the points in order from the first point to the last. Do not join the point with a ruler. Okay, sometimes a person wants to join the points neatly, so use a ruler, no need for that. So we plot the points in the order from the first to the last. Let's start with the first point. At 0 minutes of boiling, the temperature was 15. At 0 minutes means at the beginning of the experiment, the temperature was 15. So we put the point here. Okay. The next point is at 1 minute, the temperature was 18 degrees Celsius. So we check where's the 1 minute. 1 minute is about here. Okay. And the temperature is 18. It is about here. Okay. At 5 minutes, the temperature is 46. Let's see where's 46. Above 45 here. Okay. And we continue on until we finish the whole, all the points. 15, 60. Okay, now after we plot of the points, and notice here, for example, 27. 27 is not found here, but we can find it. It's between 25 and 30. It's nearer to 30, so it's here. Okay. Now we start joining the points. Join the first point to the second to the third, and so on. So your copy book will be better. And this is just the shape of the curve. Okay. Of course, after we're done, we have to give a title, and the title should have the form, a graph showing the variation of the measured factor as a function of the manipulated factor. This is the best form of the title of a graph. So we put the title, a graph showing the variation of temperature of alcohol as a function of time of boiling. Here, this way, we are done drawing this graph. Now another example, another experiment. In order to study the importance of mechanical digestion, an experiment was done where two tubes A and B contained 5 grams of meat mixed with a specific protease under the convenient conditions. The meat in tube A was in one piece, while that in tube B was cut into small pieces. So here the objective of the experiment is to study The importance of mechanical digestion. الهدف إن ندرس أهمية mechanical digestion. So we put two tubes. Each of them has 5 grams of meat. The first one is meat is in one piece, while the other is cut in two pieces. وبعدين لحم حطيناهم باثنين test tubes. بأول test tube قطعة اللحم كانت شقفة واحدة, بينما بتاني test tube قطعناها لقطع صغيرة. Here the factors are first the measured the manipulated factor is the size of the meat, while the measured factor is the mass of the meat. Okay, let's start the same steps. Here is the table. Okay, we see the time and the mass of the meat in the two tubes. And notice here we have the problem that we have two tubes. How are we supposed to draw a graph showing two tubes, not only one? We'll see later on. First, we draw the axes, as we said, the x-axis and the y-axis. The x-axis shows the manipulated, the time here. And here, as we notice, the time is not the manipulated factor. It's just the where we take the measurement. And the y-axis shows the measured factor, which is the mass of meat. Okay, now we will, the second, step is assign a scale. Here, we chose a scale, for example, on the y and the x-axis, as we see here, we have the time 0, 1, 2, 3. So it's very easy to divide it. Each 3, for example, boxes is 1 hour. While on the y-axis, we can choose another scale. The highest number is 5. We can take each 2 boxes 1 gram. Okay? Okay, we see how to, we put the scale on each x. Now we will show the scale. For the reader, each 3 boxes on x axis is 1 hour, and each 2 boxes on y axis is 1 gram. Now let's go back to the table. We want to see that the next step is to plot the points and join them. Here we have the problem of having two tubes, as we said, tube A and tube B. Here, if you remember, as we said at the beginning, that sometimes we need to use a key in a graph. Here comes the use of the key, because we have to draw two curves. Change the shape of the curve in order to differentiate between them. So we will use a key where cube A will, the curve of cube A will be drawn in blue, and the curve of cube B will be drawn in red. We have to show the key for the red. Let's start drawing the two curves. Cube A, at first, when we want to draw, we have to finish the first curve. When we're done with it, we start with the second curve. يعني لما بدنا نرسم هيك جراف في اثنين رسمتين او منحنيين بنرسم اول منحنى بنخلص منه على الاخر وبنرجع بنرسم الثاني. Okay, so let's start. Cube A at time 0 it was 5, then 3, then 1, then 0. Let's start plotting the point in blue. Choose the color blue. At 0 it was 5, at 1 it was 3, at 2 it was 1, and at 3 it is. Okay, we join the point. So this is cube A as the key. Now let's go to cube B. Let's go back to the table. At time 0 it was 5 also, then 2, then 0, then 0. So the first point is 5. At 1 it is 2. At 5 it, at 2 hours it's 0. And at 3 hours it is 0. We will also join the point. And notice how to join this. You have to join them on the x-axis. Okay. Now here we're done as the key says. Of course, the last step is to give a title. And here the title is a graph showing the variation of the mass of meat with and without mechanical digestion. We don't say with time, because the manipulated factor here is with mechanical digestion or without mechanical digestion. In A there is no mechanical digestion, while in B there was mechanical digestion. We have to show it in the slide. So until now we have done 2 examples of the graph. I hope you understood everything. Thanks for your attention, and see you later with another video.